How do your products use or challenge conventions, and how do they represent social groups or issues?
In our short film, we challenge conventions by not going the normal route for distribution while researching different ways that we could distribute our film. We found that a subscription service was one of the most popular ways to distribute. We knew that we wanted to release it through YouTube, which is a very accessible streaming website that's currently online. We found that YouTube had pretty recently released their own subscription service in October 2015, and they have mostly stuck to releasing miniseries on YouTube Red, but not necessarily a short film. So we wanted to change that. And we also chose to use cutaway credits instead of rolling credits because of our stylistic choices of our film. Our short film is about loneliness and how humanity is affected by it. And it's meant to be a parallel to Generation Z. Generation Z is constantly being watched online and is becoming increasingly more lonely with social media. And because social media is being people's false sense of their life and reality, and that's what we wanted to play into in our short film. So in Alex's life, he has a false sense of what it is of being alone in a post-apocalyptic world when he's actually hallucinating, and different scenarios like the walkie-talkie scenes and things like that, and he's actually being watched by the government.
How do the elements of your production work together to create a sense of branding?
We decided to stick to specific colors when we were editing or editing pictures from when we filmed. And we really wanted to focus on greens and blues to exaggerate the natural elements featured in both our short film and postcard. Both of these things were really important because the entire movie is set in nature. And from previous research I did about this specific genre, setting was the most important part to make your audience believe where they were and like where the movie is set. So we wanted to include that in our short film. So that's what we based around the entire thing. So like we wanted to rely on nature being our main focus for our short film, since that is the setting of it. And our main character, Alex, has his notebook throughout his months of being alone, and he constantly documented days alone, like diary entries, and we wanted to incorporate the handwriting in our credits and website and our postcard advertisement because that what made it more personable to our character. And we also chose to introduce the movie title as the cover of his notebook in the messy handwriting to again incorporate it with that. And our website is also based around these colors and this messy handwriting font. And with each page having accents of green, and the pictures featured on the homepage are mostly blue. So that's how we tie it all in. So everything is looking similar with setting, colors, and font choice.
How do your products engage with the audience, and how would they be distributed as real media products?
Our short film will engage with the audience because it is very similar to a dystopian type movie and with a post-apocalyptic setting. So with our main character being alone and a teenager, he relates to our target audience of 18 to 25 years old because they are the people watching and using YouTube daily. And we decided on sticking to YouTube as our main and only distributor and have it only available on YouTube Red. We chose this route because YouTube Red is an up-and-coming streaming subscription service that is used by around 1.5 million people. And we would use this platform because a user can try YouTube Red for free for a week and people can still access our film without being a subscriber. And we thought that was best for us. So not only are we relating it to one specific audience on YouTube, we're also leaving that little chance open for new subscribers and new people who want to try out YouTube Red and see our short film.
How did you integrate technologies, software, hardware, and online into this project?
So our entire project started with online. I started by researching on Google different movies because we already came up with a setting and like our story pretty much and how we wanted it to be. And we knew we wanted it to be like a post-apocalyptic setting. And honestly, without researching, I wouldn't have never known that that's actually a subgenre of sci-fi. So that really helped, all that research, knowing exactly what we needed to include in our short film to make our audience understand what's going on and what especially the setting was the most important part of making our audience believe it was post-apocalyptic. And we also used Google Docs to collaborate on different things like our script, our summaries, and also storyboard we shared through there when we weren't in class together. And then we also used Premiere Pro and Adobe Photoshop and Lightroom, all 2018 versions, because we knew those were the three that we both knew the best. And we used Premiere for editing because we're both certified in it, and we thought it'd be the best to edit our project itself because we knew different effects we could do, audio, video, all those different things. And then Photoshop we used for our postcard because, again, we're both certified in it, so we knew it best. And that was the easiest for us to do. For our postcard in the picture that we did end up using, I edited out all the clouds, and I don't think I would have been able to do that on any different software, so that really helped. And Lightroom really helped increase the quality of our pictures and really stick to our branding of the greens and blues, because that's what I would up the contrast in each and like brighten the photos, just really like exaggerate the natural colors. And then we also used both of our laptops, which are Mac laptops. We used a few different DSLRs, one specifically for filming and then one for taking pictures. And then we also used a Ronin to capture different shots for especially our long take at the end. That was super important. And we also used a slider and a tripod for specific shots that we wanted. We also used a shoulder mount for most of our shots because that's what looked best, because we wanted it to be a more emotional feel. So that helped with the more of a shaky shot. And we also chose to use a drone to also incorporate the government watching. And we used Tascam for specific audio we needed to record. So not only like natural sound, but dialogue.